Hello, this is a Hammerwatch 2 demo. Hammerwatch 2 comes out in August. Been a long wait. This is going to be a video about Zydar's game, where you can play like a sort of chess game of sorts while waiting. So if you enable the HUD for always show HUD overlay, it will show you the time of day. It takes about like one minute every 3 seconds, yeah. Anyway, it's so like if you want to wait for better items to spawn for him to sell, which happens every, I don't know, like 30 hours, 24 hours, I'm not really sure exact number. You can play the game while waiting. Good day. You can just keep playing even though he runs out of money, because there's nothing stopping you from betting money when he's out of money. Mm. I think a dev set was a feature, but anyway, that's just how it works. So the aim of this game is to destroy the opponent's castle while keeping yours alive. Each hit from the cannonball does 15 damage. This is actually not a bad hand. I'm just gonna discard all. What we want to do is just build some barriers. There's two strategies to come up with. So, but primarily you want to keep the cannons all the way at the far back. They take up two slots, and the slot in front of them has to be free for them to shoot the other ones, otherwise they destroy whatever's directly in front of them. You only need one spot open, so you can stack two in front of each other. So it's some, if you want like concentrated firepower, you have one here, one in the very front, and then like a wall here just to protect in case something goes wrong. And out of that, you just want to just build as much walls as possible. Whatever you start off with, sometimes if you get like really janky mess, it can be really bad. Sometimes if you have the earthquake, it might be nice to clear off your own. They do destroy your own cannons, and that can be a bad thing, but it can also be a good thing to clear out the opponent's cannons. It's very RNG, so nothing might not happen at all. And other times you might just nuke yourself and have the opponent still down. So I only recommend nuking the battlefield if you have repair walls. The NPC basically never uses earthquake, and they also practically never use repair walls. They just keep discarding as well. They primarily focus on cannon shooting for some reason. You can use the discard and these repairs, the repair 5, they're basically a free turn. I'm just cycling. Oh, so you can see there's an earthquake here. I'm not going to use it. I want to see if I can discard. Yes, so discard came up here. I want to discard it. So basically you want to stock up as many cannons as possible. And you want to also stock up as many shoot cannons late game after you have all your cannons. You don't want to use them where you only have two or three left, unless you like want to clear out something, like say you see these two cannons, they will be a major threat, so it might actually be worth me just destroying the primer quickly. Unfortunately I don't have any shoot, so build walls, so I just have to shoot really. Probably shouldn't have clicked this. Oh, he destroyed the... I think he had two cannons and one of them destroyed the other. But there's an earthquake and there's a repair walls, but I don't want to use it because then it destroys my own cannons. Because I have a superior advantage, I don't need Earthquake. Having Earthquake actually just puts me at disadvantage. The repairs I don't need, so I just use it. The two cans also free turn. So just use it if you want to use up the slots. I want to destroy that cannon soon, eventually. Got two repair walls now. Okay, the cannon's down. These big walls are very handy early game for covering large areas, but once you start cramming up your battle space, they're a hindrance. You don't want them. The one I just discarded just now was a repair 50 points for your castle. It takes up a turn though, so it's kind of like, you know, if you're in a situation that you need it, you've already fucked up basically. I need to throw a card with, so I just use it. Oh, actually you could use this one instead. Doesn't matter. I was constantly using Earthquake because I have all these repair walls that I might as well use. Right, just to be sure. Oh, enemy died anyway. Let's see what you have. Not too good, not too good. So the one I crafted is pretty redonkulous. We got attack leech, life leech, spell leech. It's actually not that great. Where is it? Well, 2.5% is actually not that bad, but the main signet one is have a signet that's more useful in most situations. But I keep it keep both of them because if I'm low in health and I can maintain distance, like I have enough stamina, I'll just use this to recover some health temporarily.
Good day.
Anyway, back to the game. So this one is a bad start for us. Might have to push your cans forward here if I do start placing some of them. I'm gonna start putting my usual forward walls. So the NPC put a can here. If I can get it to destroy this one, I can put a cannon there, and then before I put the repair walls. My hand is not that good though. curious. So this block here is going to be a bit annoying because I won't be able to put a cannon here. Put a fucking wall. Alright. So we're out of shots now. So he will have the vantage, but I can just set up more of these. There we go, I can place a cannon. And repair it. Ah shit. You want to save these up. I meant to select the flat one. Because they attack and rose, you could put a... Because you can't repair the wall with these because it's horizontal. So I got nothing back. Fine. Don't need that cannon. I might just fill in a space here. There's nothing much I can do here. Actually, I can place another cannon down. And I can discard. Let's prepare first. Discard. Should have shot it. Cannons can also act as walls because they eat up two shots. So this one won't be a shoe, he has to destroy the wall in front of it first. Ah shit, it's got two in a row here, so this is going to be concerning. Maybe shooting in. Got a bunch of shots. This next volley won't kill it, won't win me the game, but don't really have much other choice. Discard my hand. Oh, I can just win.
Hi. I'm in for a good deal. Good day.
We'll do one more. The reason why I left this space in front of here is because I can put two more cannons there on top of the ones behind. I had a cannon. I didn't realize I had this cannon card. I could have shot the cannon back and destroyed it. Oh well, it's a bit too late on that now. Just gonna continue building my fortification. Game's really not giving me a choice here. Right. Okay, I might not be able to kill it. Hang on. Okay, I can kill it. Shouldn't have clicked it. That was the one and only free lane as well. I won't be able to win now. One more shot. I need three more shots to land, to kill, to win. Well, I think this game's pretty much won now. Yep.
Hi. Let's see what you have to offer.
Oh my god, this is laggy. OBS is not like running with Hammerwatch in background. Oh yeah, the save system, in case anyone's wondering, is just you need to enter a new area. So there's a door down here.
That skill is not ready. Impossible.
Impossible. To be honest, the voice acting kind of cringy. So, when I go down these stairs, I should save. There you go, there's a save.